What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to Gig Nation. Jonathan here. Today we're going to be looking at something that's been going on with the Amazon Flex program for a while now. We've been seeing Amazon Flex kind of dwindle down in a lot of different locations across the country, and a lot of people are speculating that Amazon Flex might disappear completely. So we're going to take a look at a Business Insider article today that covers the matter. It talks to a bunch of different Amazon Flex delivery drivers and a couple of sources on the inside of the Amazon Flex program. We're going to get into all of that, and then I'm going to give you guys kind of my opinion, what I've seen here through delivering with Amazon Flex up until I was deactivated last week, what I saw with the program and what I think it's going to look like going forward for Amazon Flex delivery drivers. If you deliver for Amazon Flex, make sure to leave a comment down below and let me know what you're seeing in your area. If you've seen the same steady output of blocks and routes through the Amazon Flex app, or if you've noticed a decline in your area, because it's definitely going to vary location to location. So I want to get a good consensus going of how this is shaping up in different areas. All right, so let's pull up the Business Insider article here. And basically the headline says it all. It's very dramatic. It says that Amazon Flex is dying. And we get a couple of different perspectives here. Some Amazon Flex drivers seem to be in locations where Amazon Flex has scaled back a lot. Amazon Flex actually closed down the program entirely in Greensboro, North Carolina, and that shook up a lot of drivers. And then we're hearing a lot from other Amazon Flex drivers that more packages are being given to DSPs. We're seeing more white vans pick up these packages and less Amazon Flex routes. And Business Insider even talks to a source that says they have knowledge of the internal structure of the Amazon Flex program. And essentially that source has stated that these new DSPs are basically delivering packages at a lower rate per package than Amazon Flex. So it makes sense for Amazon's bottom line to go with the DSPs over Flex. And the sum and substance of the article is basically that Amazon Flex has been scaled back in a lot of places and may continue to be scaled back in a lot of places, but might not disappear completely. And so this is my perspective on the article, what my take is. I think it's a pretty fair article. I would like if they had talked to more sources because it's Business Insider and they definitely have the resources to do so. But I think that they got the picture mostly right. I think Amazon is definitely favoring this new business model of utilizing DSPs. I think that they probably get this at a lower rate. I think that they might also have concerns with AB5 in California, how that's shaping up, how that could impact the hiring of independent contractors for Flex going forward, and they want to definitely still be able to deliver packages. So just the uncertainty there is enough to make them go towards these DSPs. Now, they could also possibly get a lower rate if they structure it well and plan a lot of their demand out. And this is kind of how I think it will shape up, because I think that they want a set number of DSPs that cover, you know, a bulk of their demand in any given area, maybe like 70-80% of it. And then they kind of acknowledge that there's going to be fluctuations that they can't predict entirely and perfectly. So they still want Amazon Flex drivers on the road in these areas to accommodate that and to take up some of the slack where DSPs can't cover packages. But what that really means is that these Amazon Flex drivers are kind of just getting the scraps that are left over. And it also means that the program is going to be scaled back in a lot of areas. The Amazon Flex drivers are going to be seeing less packages. And as an Amazon Flex driver, as someone who knows how the pay structure is kind of formatted, you know that the rates for taking a block and taking deliveries definitely increase if there's not enough drivers out there to pick up all the blocks. So assuming that you keep a similar or same amount of Amazon Flex drivers on the road, but put less blocks out there, now all of a sudden you're going to be seeing a lot of these blocks priced towards the lower end of that spectrum, closer to that $18 an hour, as opposed to these higher paying blocks that we've seen in the past where demand really spikes, Amazon can't cover it, and all of a sudden you get that huge hourly rate that you really like to see as an Amazon Flex delivery driver. So it's kind of unfortunate the way that things are shaking out, but Amazon Flex has always been a flexible program for drivers, and it's also been a flexible program for Amazon. They want to be nimble and they want to negotiate, you know, the best possible rates for them so that they can get these packages delivered quickly to their customers. And this might leave drivers kind of wondering what the best next go-to move is. Should you start delivering for a DSP? So personally, I have not delivered for a DSP. I want to make that clear. I'm not going to tell you guys it's a great gig. I've seen some negative articles through Business Insider painting a pretty bad picture, but I've also talked to a lot of people that do deliver for DSPs, and I've had a lot of people commenting in on the channel that deliver for DSPs saying that's a pretty good gig. They're making solid daily wages, solid hourly wages, and they're also getting some benefits out of it. and they're not driving their own cars. So there's a lot of perks to this over that, you know, flexible business model that comes with a lot of on-demand delivery apps. The fact that you don't put wear and tear on your own car and you actually get some benefits out of it is a pretty good deal. But as we've seen in the past, we don't really know how this is going to play out going forward. DSPs might be profitable in one area because at the end of the day, they are independent companies operating each DSP. So while you might have a DSP that's great to work in Southern California, there might be another one in Florida that's actually has a terrible manager that, you know, reduces rates for drivers and maybe provides less benefits. It's really hard to, you know, tell how it's going to work out in any given area. Because of the way that it's set up and structured. And it's also tough to say what the rates are going to be from Amazon going forward, top level to these DSPs. They could easily cut those rates. We see Amazon cut rates for different programs all the time. Once they have enough suppliers, once they have enough DSPs out there, all of a sudden they might see that these DSPs are very replaceable and they can cut wages, cut rates for DSPs if they're not performing at a high enough metric. So yes, that was purely speculation on my part. I'm going to continue to speculate going forward because I do see certain patterns in the way that Amazon and other companies do business. And it's nice to kind of give that perspective to people that might be considering working for DSPs or operating their own DSPs because it's kind of, you see a lot of positive marketing out there of the total potential upside, but you don't always hear as much about the downside. So I like to try and give that a devil's advocate and play the other side there. If you have delivered for a DSP, make sure to leave a comment down below. Let me know what the experience was like, if you enjoyed it, and if you actually made pretty good money and where you actually deliver at. I'd love to get the conversation going with that. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. And as always, check out gigsharks.com to find the best gigs in your area. I've been working really hard on this website, and it would be great if you could check it out if you're looking for some extra side hustles or app jobs to work for.